Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 28th of July. India's first mother-to-child vertical transmission of COVID-19 recorded in Pune. Monsoon floods kill at least 8 in Pakistan's Karachi. And UN says nearly 3,500 Afghans killed or hurt in first half of 2020. And now for all the details. India's first documented case of vertical transmission of COVID-19 from a mother to child has been recorded by a hospital in western Pune city. Hospital authorities said the newborn baby required intensive care but recovered completely over a period of 3 weeks. India's COVID-19 tally neared 1.5 million mark on Tuesday, with the country adding more than 45,000 cases to its total for the sixth consecutive day.
The Sassoon General Hospital in Pune city of India's Maharashtra state on Tuesday claimed that it has found the country's first case of vertical transmission of the COVID-19 from a mother to her child through the placenta. According to the hospital, the newborn required intensive care but recovered completely over a period of 3 weeks. Vertical transmission of an infection occurs from a mother to the child in the uterus through the placenta, a temporary organ that develops in the uterus during pregnancy and provides oxygen and nutrients to the growing baby. Meanwhile, Rajendra Institute of Medical Sciences, the largest hospital in India's eastern Jharkhand state, began collection of plasma from those who have recovered from COVID-19. Convalescent plasma therapy, which involves administering of antibodies from recovered person's body to a patient's body, has shown encouraging results across India.
यहाँ से 4 लोग आज डोनर है दे रहे हैं तो चूंकि इससे बॉडी का जो प्रतिरोधात्मक क्षमता है वो बढ़ेगा और जब प्रतिरोधात्मक क्षमता बढ़ेगा तो स्वाभाविक रूप से मरीज को इसका लाभ मिलेगा और हम समझते हैं कि ये इसके बाद हम जमशेदपुर और भी जगह पर इसको बहुत जल्दी जल्दी तेज गति में करने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं.
India's COVID-19 tally on Tuesday neared the 1.5 million mark, with the country adding more than 45,000 cases to its total for the sixth consecutive day, and the toll now stands at 33,425. Health Ministry has said despite rising cases, the recovery rate among COVID-19 patients is now 64.24%, while the fatality rate is 2.25%.
In news from Pakistan, at least 8 people have lost their lives as the third spell of monsoon rain has flooded Pakistan's biggest city, Karachi. Flood water has accumulated in low-lying residences and on the roads in the commercial districts, hampering traffic and forcing residents to wade through knee-high or waist-high water.
At least 8 people have died in rain-related incidents so far as the third spell of monsoon rain has flooded Pakistan's biggest city and commercial capital of Karachi. Karachi has been receiving heavy rains from past few weeks, which has flooded low-lying areas, inundating roads and causing power outages. Rescue officials from Eidi Foundation, a non-profit organization that runs a network of ambulances, said most of the deaths occurred due to electrocution.
देखिए जो कल बारिश हुई थी उसके निस्बत जो अभी जो बारिश शुरू हुई थी 11 बजे से 3 बजे तक जो बारिश चली है नॉर्थ नाजमाबाद और सहेजीकोम सराबपुर की तरफ या सरजानी की तरफ और कल की और आज की टोटल तादाद मिला के टोटल हलाकतें 8 हुई हैं जिसमें ज़्यादातर करंट लगने से हलाकतें हुई हैं और कुछ हलाकतें जो हैं वो नदी में बहने से हुई हैं.
The first spell of monsoon hit Karachi in the first week of July, disrupting electricity for hours and causing traffic jams on almost every major thoroughfare. On July 18, Karachi saw the second spell of heavy rain again. The city suffered similar losses, including traffic jams, flooding of roads and destruction of infrastructure.
Moving on, Locals in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have accused that Pakistan and the Stooge government in the region has failed to address the public's concerns and have put them on pity of circumstances amid the coronavirus pandemic. They have blamed the pandemic as acting as salt on their wounds as the government continues to neglect their demands for relief and improvement in the healthcare sector.
Locals in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have raised concern over neglect by Islamabad amid coronavirus pandemic and the indifference towards the development of the illegally occupied region. They have blamed Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has not fulfilled any promise that he committed on the eve of election 4 years ago and continues to remain missing from his constituency amid the coronavirus pandemic. A local claimed the government has not provided any COVID-19 relief to the public in over 3 months long lockdown in the illegally occupied region.
ये मेन रोड है मुफ्फाबाद की बैंक चला है और इसके मतलब है जगह जगह खड्डे पड़े पूरे मुफ्फाबाद में ये बीघा दल हुकूमत है एक किलोमीटर रोड ठीक नहीं है एक किलोमीटर रोड चार साल में आप इतने नायल हैं इतने निकम्मे इतने नायक हैं एक किलोमीटर रोड आप ठीक नहीं कर सकते कोरोना की वबा आई पाकिस्तान के चारों सूबों में वजाय आला ने आपने पैकेज दिया रीपैकेज दिया आपने हमें एक टका नहीं दिया आपने आपकी आपकी हुकूमत की सपाट किया
पाकिस्तान एडमिनिस्टर्ड कश्मीर हैज रिपोर्टेड 2040 कंफर्म्ड कोविड-19 केसेस एंड 49 डेथ्स सो फार Locals in the illegally occupied region have blamed the pandemic is acting as salt on their wounds as the government has continued to neglect their demands for relief and improvement in healthcare sector.
With Eid al-Adha, the Muslim festival of sacrifice, just around the corner, sales are not as good as usual for cattle traders in Pakistan, as people who usually buy sacrificial animals ahead of the festival are going online, rather than visiting the dusty markets to mark their purchases amid the coronavirus concerns.
Business is not as robust as usual for cattle traders in Pakistan, as people who usually buy sacrificial animals ahead of the Muslim festival of Eid al-Adha are going online rather than to dusty markets to make their purchases amid the coronavirus concerns. The government has imposed social distancing restrictions, including a half-day closure of the markets, to discourage crowds that gather at the markets. This too has led to a drop in customers set up on the outskirts of urban centers ahead of one of Islam's most important festivals.
पिछले साल कारोबार अच्छा था 24 घंटे गिराक आता था इस वक्त जो है ना 12 घंटे कर दिया गिराक बहुत कम लग रहा है हम व्यापारी लोग बहुत परेशान है अच्छा इसकी वजह से जो है ना गिराक दिन में आता है दिन में गर्मी बहुत होता है रात को वो बोल दिया कि नहीं है गिराक इससे हम बहुत परेशान है
Authorities are advising people to make their purchases of sacrificial animals virtually or at least wear masks when visiting cattle markets as the fair preparations for the holidays could reverse a recent decline in the country's COVID-19 infection number.
Customer to kam hai abhi market mein aaj to itwar hai halanki kafi rush hona chahiye tha lekin aaj jo hai wo kuch kam nazar aa raha hai rush wagera aur corona ki wajah se bahut sare logon ne masjidon mein hisse dale hain
While market visitors have fallen, more people are paying charities to slaughter cattle on their behalf and deliver their cut to them or donate it to the needy.
In news from Afghanistan, violence in Afghanistan, mainly between the government forces and the Taliban, killed or injured a total of 3,458 civilians in the first half of 2020. The United Nations has said in its latest report. The UN, while raising concern over the casualties, has urged parties to prioritize protection of the civilians as fighting rages in Afghanistan despite a pact between the United States and the Taliban.
The UN has urged parties to prioritize protection of civilians in Afghanistan, start peace talks while documenting 3,458 civilian casualties in the country in the first half of 2020. Said latest UN Assistant Mission in Afghanistan or UNEMA report. At the time when the government of Afghanistan and the Taliban have a historic opportunity to come together at the negotiation table for peace talks, The tragic reality is that the fighting continues, inflicting terrible harm to civilians every day, said Deborah Lyons, the head of UNEMA. According to UNEMA, women and children continue to be disproportionately affected by the direct and indirect impacts of the armed conflict, comprising more than 40% of the total civilian casualties. In February, the United States and the Taliban signed an agreement in Doha, laying out plans for the withdrawal of foreign forces from Afghanistan in exchange for security guarantees from the militants. However, fighting has spiked in recent weeks, prompted by differences over an exchange of prisoners between the Taliban and the Afghan government, as Kabul proved reluctant to free hundreds of jailed militants.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh, more than 9 million people have been affected by monsoon floods in South Asia. Floods triggered by days of heavy monsoon rains inundated residential areas near the Bangladeshi capital Dhaka on Monday, leaving families stranded.
Floods triggered by days of heavy monsoon rains inundated residential areas near the Bangladeshi capital Dhaka on Monday, leaving families stranded. Some locals in Wakurda, about 15 kilometers from the capital, took to boats to try to find shelter as the flood waters rose. Officials have said that hundreds of thousands in Bangladesh have been marooned and thousands of hectares of farmland submerged as floods hit the nation already grappling with coronavirus.
মানুষ জিনিসপত্র লয়া অন্যথা চলে যাচ্ছে আর কি বন্যা ক্ষয় ক্ষতি রাস্তা ঘাট অনেক ক্ষয় ক্ষতি হইছে আমার মার্কেটও মনে করেন পানি উঠে গেছে.
Flooding in Bangladesh has been made worse by heavy rains in the neighboring Indian state of Assam. Millions have been forced to flee their homes in Assam after the Brahmaputra River that flows from Tibet into India and then into Bangladesh burst its banks.
In news from Nepal, as the famous Pashupatinath temple dedicated to Hindu Lord Shiva in Nepal remains closed due to the coronavirus concerns, devotees prayed from outside the main gate of the temple on Monday during the holy month of Shravan. Mondays of Shravan are considered to be one of the most auspicious days as per Hindu calendar.
Hindu devotees thronged the famous Pashupatinath temple dedicated to Hindu Lord Shiva in Nepal on Monday to offer prayers during the holy month of Shravan amid the coronavirus outbreak. Hindus worship Lord Shiva by offering special prayers during the holy month of Shravan every year. Though the crowds were lesser as compared to previous years, devotees still visited the temple in large numbers and prayed from outside the main gate as the temple has been closed due to coronavirus concerns.
त्यस्तो भन्दा नि अब भगवानको घरमा टेक्न पाउनु नै सबभन्दा खुसीको कुरा हो हैन अब हामीलाई बन्द हुन्छ भनेर त थाहा छ तर पनि खुल्यो कि भन्ने सोचेर चाहिँ आको हो तर पनि भगवानको घरमा टेक्न पाउँदा त्यस्तो फिल भएको छैन पूजा गरियो हैन आफूले ल्याएको सामानहरू बाहिरै चढाउन पाइयो त्यो फिर्ता लान पाइएन त्यही हो खुसीको कुरा नै.
Regarded as most sacred temple of Hindu Lord Shiva in the world, Pashupatinath temple's existence dates back to 400 AD. Crowds visiting the temple gets doubled during Mondays of the holy month of Shravan, as considered to be one of the most auspicious days as per Hindu calendar.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. India's first mother-to-child vertical transmission of COVID-19 recorded in Pune. Monsoon floods kill at least 8 in Pakistan's Karachi. And UN says nearly 3,500 Afghans killed or hurt in first half of 2020. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.